YouTube, what's going on? Hope y'all are having a dope ass day today. It's your boy Alex and I'm back today with another reaction video. It is a good day. If you woke up feeling good, like you're gonna get shit done, then more power to you, because I woke up late and slept in. Just didn't even set my alarm. And it was the most fantastic, glorious thing. Y'all don't give a fuck about that, because we are here to continue our Kill 'Em All journey with Metallica. The song we got today is called Jump in the Fire. It's a good morning, man. Got my Black Sabbath shirt.
What?
Major shout out to Negative Creep. Go check him out on Instagram. Got my Pivot Cup.
Pivot!
Full of coffee. And it just could not get any better than this, man, so let's get it. And I am so excited for this, dude. But before we jump into the greatness, I did do a little bit of research and found something stupid awesome. And this is a long ass paragraph, so we're gonna read it pretty quick. Alongside Hit the Lights and No Remorse, Jump in the Fire is one of Metallica's first original songs, having been included in a Ron McGovney's 82 Garage demo and unreleased recording. The original lyrics and content, which dealt with sex, were written by Dave Mustaine and the former band Panic at the age of 16. The original version that Mustaine introduced to Hetfield and Ulrich upon joining Metallica was raw. The three worked together on refining the song, and the final outcome is what is heard on the demo. However, much like the events surrounding the Four Horsemen, new lyrics were written by James Hetfield upon Mustaine's departure from Metallica. The new lyrics revolve around people being damned to hell, and therefore jumping in the fire. Lars Ulrich claims that they had written the song to sound like Run to the Hills by Iron Maiden, holy shit that's cool, which was popular at the time. Current live performances since 2004 are in D standard tuning, as opposed to the E standard tuning of earlier live performances. Fun fact for you if you didn't know that about Metallica. And enough babbledock bullshit, let's jump into the video. Okay. We're gonna see how like Iron Maiden they sound. If we can tell the difference, right? I mean, I fucking like it already. It doesn't take long. That's badass, man. It's got that old school vibe because it is old school. Metallica's first album, right? But it just like, it's raw. It's a weird word if you got a sick fucking mind. But this is just pure, raw, unadulterated rawness. Rawness! If you find a person that says they don't like this song, I'd question most everything else they'd have to say. Dude. In a time, like a timeline type question, and I could easily look this up, but I like including y'all and asking you guys. I feel like it sounds like Motley Crue a little bit. I feel like Motley Crue was probably inspired by Metallica. Like, who came first? Motley Crue, Metallica? That's probably a stupid fucking question, but I don't know the answer. So I'm gonna ask it, damn it. Jump in the fire!
Come on! Jump in the fire!
I love the riff and the guitar. The riff is just so dirty. And I mean, the drums, everything about this, but like the riff and the drums are what really stands out to me. Love it. We'll be right back. I'm gonna be up here. That's what I wanna do. The frustrating thing about my life is I don't even remotely know how to play drums to look like I know. I would be cool with like just knowing something that would actually be what drummers do just to make it look like I know what I'm talking about, but I don't. But I would want to be up here. I don't know when they just... I don't know. Metallica always makes me do this type of bullshit. I'm sorry that I'll never be able to please you like that. I have shortcomings as a man. Am I proud of him? No. Could I do something about it? No, not to reach that. So yeah, basically what that song does is is a perfect combination between encouraging me to learn an instrument and discouraging me because I'll never get that good. That's essentially where I'm sitting at this. But the song, tremendously awesome. I fucking love it. 100%. I mean, it's got the old school vibe, right? Love that. You can tell it's got an authority about it. Where you're listening to it and you're like, this song caused so many generations of music that people would look up to. It's nuts! It is the quintessential example of talent being a necessary element to creating metal music. It's just a realization. Is that so new? No. That you have to actually have some fucking skill to shred out on an instrument with your cockhead. Don't know where that came from. Was it jarring? Yes. Did you like it? Probably not. Have you clicked off the video by now? Most likely. For those of y'all that haven't, I just want to say that I fucking appreciate you tremendously, dude. I love you so much. If you are watching at this point in the video, the very end, then I know that you are a real one. We are gonna keep chugging along with the Metallica album. It's taken us a little bit of time, but slow and steady wins the race, my friend. Slap your ass if you go at too quick of a pace, my friend. Anyway, love you guys. I'll see you tomorrow. That's a motherfucking fact. Oh yeah, keep smiling, keep being yourself. Don't let anybody throw shade at you. Like I just fucking said, I will see you tomorrow. It's a motherfucking fact. I love y'all. Okay? Peace!